It's time again for one of my favorite shows, the NorthWestern Berks Reptile Show, aka Hamburg. And this time around, awesomeness was in no short supply. As soon as you walked in, you were greeted by these two veterinarians from the Penn Veterinary School of Medicine. They were here to offer free services through the University of Pennsylvania School of Veterinary Medicine, which is seeking lizards to participate in a study evaluating orthopedic pain in reptiles.
So I'm standing here with Dr. Latoya. I'm going to call you Dr. Latoya. And I'm sorry, what was your name?
Colin.
Colin and Dr. Colin. Dr. Latoya and Dr. Colin are here. I'm standing at the entrance to the Hamburg Reptile Show, and it's pretty cool. They have this really, I think, awesome program going on, and I wanted to talk to them a little bit more about what it is they're doing. So why don't you tell us what it is you're offering here to the Hamburg people coming through?
Awesome. So essentially what we're doing is we're offering a free reptile pain study at the University of Pennsylvania Vet Teaching Hospital. And essentially what it is you get, if you have a pet lizard that's been injured, if they have any type of bone-related injury or if they have a bone-related illness in general, we'll do free blood work, free radiographs, and free physical exams by reptile specialists. And all we ask is that you fill out a survey to help kind of identify those behaviors you see at home that are actually related to the pain so that we know how to improve the pain medications we offer them on our end.
Interesting. Now, this is all sorts of bone issues from metabolic bone disease all the way to trauma that you're looking at.
Exactly. And it's really unique because we're finding, so far we've surveyed all of the reptile veterinarians in the country, and it's interesting. They think that they qualify pain as one way, and what we're trying to do is actually look at how the owners qualify abnormal behaviors in their pets. And because bone disease is so common in reptiles, we figure that's probably one of the best ways to begin to try to understand pain in these animals.
Now, obviously, it's important to understand it in reptiles because I think historically people perceive reptiles as one of these animals that don't exhibit a lot of pain, perhaps because they can't show it. So this would obviously lead to some kind of improvement in pain management going forward for them, I'm assuming.
Yes, very much so. It's very interesting. I'm actually doing a thesis at the medical school, and I know that sounds kind of strange, but it's so important also in the scientific community that they're paying me to actually come and try to do this free study. Turns out they have the same spinal cord and the same brain that we do, so even though they may not show pain the same way that we do, it doesn't mean that they don't have it. And so it's our jobs as veterinarians to try to identify those things that we could best figure out would represent pain to them, and basically it's through studying their behaviors, which is why we're asking the owners to let us know what they see at home.
Excellent. And you're definitely, I'm assuming, seeing an increase in pet reptiles too, which is also sparking interest.
Very much so. Historically, veterinarians who specialize in reptiles has been on a lag, but if you look at the latest numbers in the polls, reptiles have pretty much quadrupled their numbers among pet owners in the past 5 years. So there's a growing sense of appreciation for the fact that a lot of people have these very special animals. The other thing is a lot of them live for such a long period of time. So it's like I have a 52-year-old Eastern Box Turtle pet, and she's the oldest patient at Penn. So now that people are realizing that there's people who would like to see these guys and improve their medicine, we're trying to do our best to facilitate actually taking care of them better, even in the veterinary world.
Well, there you go. UPenn, awesome study. Make sure you check it out.
Thank you.
As soon as you make it inside the field house, the sights become really overwhelming. I mean, there's just so much to see and so much to do at this show. I can't even begin to tell you. The aisles are jam-packed with people, and everybody's got amazing stuff to sell, both venomous and non. I was really happy to meet up with artist and friend of the show, Zach Baez, who stopped by to show us one of his original prints, which is absolutely amazing to behold in person. He also showed us some of the prints he'll be selling. And of course, one of the major highlights for a non-venomous keeper like myself is going to Hamburg and seeing all the hot snakes. So no matter what it is you're looking for when you come to Hamburg, one thing's guaranteed, you're gonna leave here with something. It's great to see shows like Hamburg that are thriving and attracting a large number of vendors from all over the country. And you never know who you'll run into.
look later on at the...
So here at Hamburg, we've found ourselves caught up with the elusive viper keeper. Let's see if we can actually hold on to him for a second.
There's a Viper Keeper, the public figure page,
and I put
those pictures up there. Okay, very nice to meet you.
He's just such a crowd pleaser all the way around.
I do, I love him.
And we enjoy your videos, Al. You've been on the whole time here. We're trying to dig through your throgs of fans.
Okay, and more fans
just coming through and asking questions we don't even know anything about. Al, how you doing? Good to run into you here at the Hamburg, Pennsylvania show.
Yeah, this is my usual haunt on the Saturdays that it happens. Usually I'm in and out, but I'm stimulating the economy myself today and visiting with all my fans and seeing what's happening in the snake world.
Have you seen anything terribly exciting here today?
Unfortunately, not really. I saw some really hot stuff that probably shouldn't be here because no one has the serum for it. And if it bites you, you're in serious trouble. But that's normal for this type of show.
So does that concern you when you're seeing some of these animals sold that there's obviously no hope for if you get bit? I mean, is that something that's always perpetually in the back of your mind?
Well, of course it is because... you know, anybody's mistake, including my own, usually ends up reflecting on us all, whether we're good keepers or bad keepers or anything. It all shows us in a bad light. I keep a lot of the serums for what I have, so I can end up at the emergency room most of the time if I have a problem without dialing 911, which broadcasts it to the news media who listen into those scanners. And I can have it taken care of very quietly without no one knowing. But if you've got to go searching around for antivenin, first of all, you know, the first place they look is a local zoo. And, you know, I don't like to put out the zookeepers because what if their own people need the serum the following week? So getting antivenin is quite easy to do. It's just a paperwork exercise. The biggest thing is the expense, but you know, if you're going to spend a couple $100 for a venomous snake, you can at least get two or three doses of serum and spend a few $100 just to keep it on hand in case you need it. And this way, you know, you don't necessarily have to make a big noise, and it buys you time to bring in serum of from someplace else.
Now, this show seems to be a stepping stone for people moving up into the hot world. What recommendations would you have for somebody showing up here today looking to get their first hot?
Well, first of all, probably the first hot should be a domestic snake because most of the hospitals will carry the antivenin for North American rattlesnakes or moccasins. So that's pretty much the best thing to do. And there's certainly a good variety of those here. That's my recommendation, but overall, work with somebody and somebody else's snakes before you decide what you're going to do on your own. It's that learning curve. Once you get past the do's and don'ts and learn some basic husbandry, you know, unless you do something really dumb, you know, your chances of getting bit are really, really low. And buy professional grade caging. Please don't keep things in aquariums with screen tops. There's lots of vendors here that do professional grade caging. You know, that's what you really need to keep this.
Excellent advice. Thank you, Viper Keeper. I hope you have a great day here at the Hamburg Show.
Thanks very much, and a pleasure to finally meet up with you guys. I listen to you guys all the time. Great show.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right. Take care.
I always look forward to seeing one of my favorite vendors at this show, Max Pet. I thought I'd stop by and say hi to Patrick, the owner. See what's shaking.
So I'm standing here with Patrick Loftus from Max Pet. Now, if you haven't made it to any of the shows in the Northeast, then you don't know what a tremendous presence Max Pet is at these shows. Basically, one of the largest vendors offering everything and anything you would possibly need for your pets. I'm talking about from basic supplements and foods all the way to enclosures and life support equipment and all kinds of stuff. Patrick, what are some of the things that you can expect to find at the Max Pet Corner when you visit a show?
We pretty much try to carry as much as we can physically get into our trucks and trailers. Pretty much everybody expects us to have all the new products. at a competitive pricing. We undoubtedly bring the largest selection of reptile products and supplies available. We're constantly looking to push the envelope to find new things to bring, new services, and we try to bring everything.
So it seems you're constantly bringing new products to the show and stuff that you typically don't see, and also you offer the ability to pick up these larger items without shipping costs, which is a huge benefit. So you kind of do all the work. Thank you for that, for hauling everything. And I got to tell you, the amount of stuff you bring is just absurd. I mean, how long does it take you to set up in the mornings before getting ready?
We've done like White Plains in here in 2 hours. We like more time. But we've pretty much got it down to a science.
So Patrick is working for you people. Patrick is busting his ass every morning, getting all this stuff up here ready for you guys. So appreciate it and come visit Max Pet and definitely make sure you buy. Patrick, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you very much. Have a good show.
And a good show it is, if not one of the best in the Northeast. Hamburg never disappoints with the variety of things that are available at this show. I mean, you literally see a little bit of everything. And a lot of times, things you didn't expect.
Oh, we're not getting... do you have any fucking idea how many countries I'm wanted in?
Thank you, Limey. Thank you very much. Limey Smidger, a.k.a. Limey Bastard. One of our favorite vendors here at Hamburg. Limey, how the hell are you, man?
Hungover, working, trying to sell a...
How are the women at the show today?
I don't know. I don't see any.
That's a problem, isn't it?
There's really nothing you want to tamper with, is there?
No, it's not here, at least not without a lot of
protection. The Californian shows are the best ones for the chicks.
So, okay, so hands down, best show in the country for chicks?
California.
Yeah?
Yeah. Out in Rami's show to San Diego.
Who puts out more?
I don't know.
Liar.
Yeah, I'm lying. I don't know.
Awesome. Well, what did you bring today, Limey?
I've got some nice ball pythons. I got some, I don't know, shit over there.
All kinds of cool shit.
Go and put the camera over there because I don't remember.
Put the camera over there.
Super stripes.
Limey's just all sort of screwed up.
Don't know.
Okay. Well,
snakes, geckos, shit, stuff.
Another groundbreaking interview at Urban Jungles Radio. Thank you.
The way it goes.
So, do yourself a favor. If you find yourself in the vicinity of the NorthWestern Berks Reptile Show, make sure you check it out. Even if you're going to check out the hot snakes, I promise you won't be disappointed. You'll probably even see us there.
With your hosts, Danny Mendez and Andy V.